We're at the Deco Hi-Wide booth with Robert Lewis. Now, as many of you folks know, Ed and I both currently wear the Deco Hi-Wide shooting glasses in corrected lenses, and I think that's one of the unique things that you bring to the market is you know, the ability to make very high quality shooting glasses with that corrected lens. Now, one of the things we didn't cover in some of the information that we put out before is lens materials. What are the considerations and what's currently available that people should be thinking about?
Lens material plays a huge key, especially in prescription eyewear. You know, you have regular materials that you see out on the market. CR39 is something they use in the regular optical market. Not always the best for a shooting application, which is what we're dealing with in this industry. Polycarbonate is usually the first standard that everybody knows. Doesn't matter what manufacturer out there. Generally, that's kind of your benchmark. And it's a great lens, but there are some ceilings there or a level at which the prescription starts to exceed to where the patient or the customer or the wearer being the shooter might start having a problem with the clarity of that material. There's another material out there that's not really well known yet, and it's called Tribex. Tribex is a material that you see out on the market in the optical world now, but it's becoming more prevalent even in the shooting glasses, and that's a material that affords better optical clarity in those higher prescriptions. I know originally, and I know in your previous videos, Ed's mentioned the fact that you used to have a really high prescription, and that's something that would have been right in the ballpark for Ed's glasses, is to be in that Tribex lens, just to afford him better optics in those really high prescriptions, and still give him the great protection that polycarbonate would.
Gotcha. Now, in a Tribex lens, in a higher prescription, is that gonna give you the ability to get, you know, a thinner lens versus thicker, or?
Not necessarily. Lenses and their different materials is all about what there's a term in the optical world that we use, it's called indices of refraction, or how light refracts through that material. It also affects the thickness of it. Polycarbonate is actually a little thinner than Tribex, but it's all about its optical quality and that indices of refraction. It's actually the closer you can get to glass for the indices of refraction is going to give you better clarity. And that Tribex is closer to glass than polycarbonate. So that's what gives it that closer pairing or that number of that indices of refraction gives it a better clarity than polycarbonate and affords the wearer that has that higher prescription to wear that material and not have any problems with the optical clarity of it.
Now, in making that comparison or that decision between should I go polycarbonate versus Tribex, what other factors are there, like price or things like that?
Price is really pretty negligible. I know for Deco Hi-Wide, polycarbonate's about a $75 upgrade as far as we kind of base everything off a base price point because we do sell glasses for other non-shooting sports. So we kind of have a base. We add polycarbonate for all our shooting type stuff. And then Tribex would be a $100 upgrade. So $25 difference, not a big, you know, gap there. And it's something that the user can actually make that choice as far as if they want that material. If they're ever questioning that, that's where our staff comes in. We are in the office Monday through Friday. Our hours are kind of weird. They're 6:30 in the morning until 3:30 in the afternoon. We're dealing a lot more with the middle part of the country, the Midwest, back east, and so we keep some earlier hours. The thing of it is whenever we're open, you're gonna get a live person. And those live people are opticians. And opticians are the people that build the glasses, know how to put those combinations together. So when we take your prescription, we're looking at what type of shooting that the wearer is going to be doing, their prescription, and we're automatically formulating what those products are going to be best. So they may call in and they want a polycarbonate lens or something like that, and we look at their prescription, and that's where we're going to start to guide them more into that more appropriate material.
Now, for folks calling in, I mean, typically, how's that conversation go? You know, they say you have a corrective prescription lens. What are the sort of things that you would typically ask them?
Well, that's actually one of the first things we ask. We want to see the prescription because having the prescription in front of us before we start talking about product selection keeps us for guiding them into materials that they really shouldn't be wearing or options that may be not available to them because of their prescription. So one of the first things we do ask for is a copy of the prescription. We want their pupillary distance measurement. That's the measurement between the centers of the pupils. That's how anybody in optics aligns the prescription with the eyes so that they see properly. It basically refracts the light through the lenses and aligns with the eyes. So we want that. And at that point in time, then we start talking about what type of shooting they're doing. Lighting conditions, their sensitivity to light. So in bright sunny days, do we need to do a sunglass density lens for somebody that's really light sensitive? Or can we get away with a lighter shade that's gonna afford them more light coming in? They're gonna see better and not take too much light away and make it harder to see and affect their depth perception and their visual acuity.
Now, coatings is another option. Let's talk a little bit about that.
coatings available out there. Everything that you see in the optical world that we deal with is going to have a scratch-resistant coating on there. You can't really do, some people maybe have heard about like a hard coating or a scratch-proof coating or something like that. There are some hard coats out there. The reason that we don't use them is because we're tinting lenses. Okay. When you tint lenses, tint cannot go through that hard coating. It's just it's hard. It won't permeate into the lens. So everything we do is a scratch-resistant coating, and as long as you care for them with the products that we provide, always provide lens cleaner cloths, lens cleaner itself, and a proper way to store them. That's about the best thing you can do as long as you take care of your eyewear, just like you take care of your guns or any of your other, wares or anything like that, or everything you'd use out on the range. You want to take care of those products. So as long as you do that, other coatings, anti-reflective coatings. That's one other coating that people may know from their regular eyewear. Okay. That particular coating is for glare reduction. You should be able to see anybody that's got an anti-reflective coating like the glasses I have on. You don't see the actual lens because all light is transmitting through it.
I see.
You could put that coating on anything. Sometimes it's not really probably going to have a lot of effectiveness. We use it a lot for night shooting, shooting indoors where we want to bring in more light and transmit every ounce of available light. I do have some wearers out there that are very light sensitive. They may wear an anti-reflective coating on their daily wear glasses, and they know that if they don't have it, that that's going to affect their vision, and they're going to perceive or they're going to see that reflection off the lens. So those are conversations that we're having as we're walking through that sales process and gathering that information about what they're doing. Those are questions that we automatically ask.
Very good.
Yeah.
Well, Robert, that's very good information. And we really appreciate you spending the time with us here at SHOT Show.
Well,
best of luck in 2017.
Thank you very much. We appreciate you stopping by.
Good.
All right.